Good morning and welcome to the Berks County Board of Commissioners meeting for April the 23rd of 2020. We're going to begin with a moment of silence followed by a pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I want to note that anyone watching that would like to ask a question, either about the published agenda or make comment, and not really question, comments, please email us at comments@countyofberks.com. The email is comments@countyofberks.com. That is being monitored by my executive assistant, and we actually have three questions that, not questions, comments, we've already responded to, but I will reference them. And if there are any additional comments, we will share them at the same time. I do want to note that we have continued to meet daily with the COVID-19 leadership team at 1 p.m. Since our last meeting, which was on April the 9th. The exception was this past Sunday, April the 19th, we did not have a call. Those meetings dealt with personnel and emergency-related issues. Are there any additions or corrections for the April 9th Commissioner meeting minutes? Seeing none, the minutes will stand as presented. Before we go into the agenda, I want to make a few comments. I saw the Reading Eagle editorial this morning, and it makes a point, I think a legitimate point, that the county commissioners, while our message, our Do Your Part campaign, they praise that the idea of promoting it at a public event, Weaver's Hardware, they felt was not appropriate and inconsistent. And I think it raises an issue that I just want to highlight. We, as commissioners, are learning what the best practices are as we go. I can say without any question, Commissioner Barnhart, Commissioner Rivera, and myself have not interjected any politics into the decisions we've made. We've simply tried, working with the best information available, to make the best decisions possible. We have had people debate whether we should speak with a mask or without a mask. We've chosen recently, after feedback from the Weavers event, to as much as possible, when in public, to speak with a mask on, out of respect for the people that may be in proximity in that particular room. We've heard over the last weeks that we're not doing enough, we're overreacting, we're over the top, we're responding to a hoax, we're hyping the hoax, that we need to do way more than we're doing. And I just want to note, there are critics everywhere, and I'm not saying that in a derogatory manner. Every one of us have an opinion of what's going on, what's right, what's wrong. But again, I want to reiterate, at the end of the day, there are only three Berks County commissioners. And each of us have been unified to do what we believe is right. I want to compliment my colleagues. At no point have I ever felt that Commissioner Barnhart or Commissioner Rivera were trying to push their own agenda, that either of them have tried to blame other people. but simply, we, all three of us have put our heads down, worked with our team, and we have a great team, and tried to determine what is the best course of action. I just want our residents to understand at the end of the day, what we're doing because we care about you. We care about our businesses, we care about the employees, we care about our residents, and we will continue to do what we believe is right. And that means from time to time, we may readjust what we are doing. I apparently forgot something. Oh, yes, there was also no call on Easter Sunday, April the 12th. I thank one of our, this is Mary Jo Gibson, our chief clerk, who's all the way in the back. But thank you for that clarification, Mary Jo. I don't know if my colleagues want to say anything before we move into the agenda, but I just wanted to set that tone up front.
What you said was well said and would be the same thing I would say, and the more I talk, the more my glasses fog up, so.
I know that feeling, too.
And I would just echo the words of both Commissioner Leinbach and Commissioner Barnhart as well. Very well said. We're here doing our best to make sure that the county can get through this in the best way possible, and always looking out for the best interest of the citizens and of the county.
Okay, we're going to move into the agenda. There are no comments at this point on specific agenda items. So number one, under authorizing budget department, adopt a resolution authorizing the following budget transfers or appropriations: 2019 appropriations in the amount of $407, 2020 budget transfers in the amount of $9,538, 2020 appropriations in the amount of $1,821,000 per listing dated April the 13th, and then 2020 budget transfers in the amount of $340,539 per listing dated April the 20th of 2020. Two items listed under Human Resources. Item A, adopt a resolution authorizing human resource recommendations per listing dated April the 23rd. Authorize the promotion of Elizabeth Monick from County Casework Supervisor to Manager of In-Home Services in Children and Youth. And item B, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the Blue Cross Administrative Services Group contracts letter for 2020 health insurance benefits. We have one item listed under Commissioner Rivera. Adopt a resolution authorizing the appointment of, is it Rafaela? Lopez, Reading, Pennsylvania, to the Children and Youth Advisory Board to fill the remainder of a three-year term, which will expire on December 31st of 2021. There are several items listed under commissioners, and I'm going to note a number of these are ratify and confirm. Because of the circumstances that we are in, there are a number of decisions that were made prior to today, and those, for the record, must be ratified and confirmed in a formal public meeting, and that's what's taking place. Item A, adopt a resolution of the County of Berks recognizing and approving the LRTA within the Township of Analani in compliance with Act Number 76 of 1977, known as the Local Economic Revitalization Tax Assistance Act, and setting a maximum exemption amount and a schedule. Item B, adopt a resolution authorizing execution of a letter of support to the Pennsylvania Department of Transportation on behalf of Carbon County, the sponsoring agency for the grant funding for their grant application for the federal year, fiscal year 2021 and 2022 Community Traffic Safety Project Program. The grant is shared with counties who adopt a letter of support and provides the ability to conduct educational programs to the public in general and in schools, as well as police departments and PennDOT. So this is a joint participation. I don't want someone to read this and think, what in the world are we doing supporting money going exclusively to carbon? It's not exclusively to carbon. Item C, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving execution of a letter in support of the Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency on behalf of Claire of Assisi House with respect to its grant application to PCCD 2019-2020 Burn JAG single solicitation of local initiatives to provide reentry programs and practices to female ex-offenders who face tremendous barriers to community reintegration and are at high risk for recidivism. Item D, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving execution of letters in support of the Pennsylvania Department of Community and Economic Development Greenways Trail and Recreation Program and the Pennsylvania Department of Conservation and Natural Resources on behalf of the Board of Supervisors of Ruscom Manor Township with respect to their application for a Greenways Trails and Recreation Program grant to provide financial assistance for a project involving improvements to Reuben Strauss Park and the Richard Seidel Park located in the township. Item E, adopt a resolution authorizing execution of the Memorandum of Understanding regarding furloughs between the County of Berks and the American Federation of State, County, and Municipal Employees District Council 88, memorializing an understanding and agreement between the county and AFSCME regarding temporarily furloughed, appointed, court-related, and residual bargaining unit employees. Item F, adopt a resolution authorizing execution of the Memorandum of Understanding between the County of Berks and Berks Connection Pretrial Services to provide reentry services in regard to the Second Chance Act community-based reentry program at the Berks County Jail. Item G, adopt a resolution authorizing the reappointment of Mitchell Darcourt, Y Missing Pennsylvania, as chairman of the Berks County Board of Assessment Appeals for a one-year term expiring December 31st of 2020. Item H, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving execution of the on-site deposit service agreement between BB&T and the County of Berks for service of remotely depositing checks in accordance with the terms and conditions of the original agreement between the parties. Item I, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving execution of Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency subgrant application, capital case indigent defense, to provide for activities that will enhance defense strategies for the indigent defendants in capital cases. Item J, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute a letter of support to the Department of Human Services Office of Long-Term Living on behalf of the Berks County Area Agency on Aging for their letter of commitment to support P4A response to OLTL application and enrollment services request for application. Item K, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving Robert Patricio, Chief Financial Officer, execution of the agreement for release of collateral between the Pennsylvania Manufacturers Association Insurance Company and the County of Berks that removes the requirement for a letter of credit to ensure the county will pay claims under the deductible for the fully insured workers' compensation policy years. Item two, a motion to ratify and confirm execution of contract agreements and amendments as furnished by the contract coordinator as set forth on the attached listing dated April the 20th of 2020. There are a total of 13 contracts. There are two with the Berksheim, one with CareerLink, one with the coroner, one with the courthouse and services center, one with the district attorney, one with Berks County Libraries, four with the commissioners, one with information systems, and one with the jail. And then a motion, item three, a motion to ratify and confirm payments as set forth on the Comptroller's Office voucher listing dated April the 14th of 2020 for the week ending April the 14th of 2020 and April the 21st of 2020 for the week ending April the 22nd of 2020 and the payment of electronic transfers and employee payroll. We've not received those documents to sign. You have them? If you could set them up on the edge there. And let me note, isn't the week ending April 15th, not 14th?
This is the 21st.
What about the 14th? Just check, if we can have the chief clerk check that date. I think on here, it normally is one day later for the week ending. Okay.
Motion to approve the agenda as presented.
Second.
The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed. The motion is carried. With that, we're going to go to the report of our treasurer. Our treasurer is not present. The general account total brought forward is $178,397,782.11. There's a balance to clear of $5,540,986.35, leaving a balance of $172,856,795.76. Again, that's the report from our county treasurer, Dennis Adams. Our county controller, Sandy Graffius, is also not present. The total cash disbursements for this period are $5,924,065.41. Does our Chief Administrative Officer Ron Seaman have anything to share?
Thank you. I have nothing at this time.
Thank you, Ron. And with that, we will turn to Commissioner comments. Oh, Commissioner Barnhart, sorry.
I was kind of waiting. After 13
years, I didn't do my proper introduction of the Commissioner Kevin Barnhart, Vice Chair of the Board of Commissioners, serving in his 13th year, married to Pamela Barnhart.
For 38 years.
For 38 years. How many children, grandchildren?
One, two.
There you go. Is that better?
Lives in Otterburg Township. That's better. Thank you. So I have a couple things to cover. Something unusual but very uplifting happened on Tuesday. I got my mail-in ballot application, my mail-in ballot, so I actually voted on Tuesday. My wife and I voted and got them back in the mail. It's part of one of my comments today is, please, we're encouraging you again to take the opportunity for mail-in or absentee ballot. The deadline to apply is May 26th. The last day to submit an absentee or mail-in ballot is June 2nd. You can go to votepa.com or to County of Berks, and on our homepage and on our election services page is the ability to produce the application for your ballot. It's very simple, it's very secret, and it's really a great way to go. So far, we've mailed out 12,000, and the reason I continue to encourage the mail-in ballot is we have thus far we have about 1,200 poll workers who work the spring and fall for us at 202 polling locations. Almost a third of them have declined to work on June 2nd. So we moved into phase two of three phases. First phase was The primary is going to occur on April 28th. Now it's moved out to June 2nd. We truly believe that's not going to be moved again. So again, emphatically, please avail yourself of mail-in and absentee ballots. Phase three would be if the state would then move to a mail-in only primary. That would be wonderful, but we don't expect that to happen. I want to thank Debbie and her staff for working tirelessly to make this thing happen. We've had several polls decide that they are not available to be used on June 2nd. They numbered almost 20, but through the efforts of Debbie and her staff have moved several. In particular, Wyomissing, the Crown Plaza will be hosting two polls, which are normally at the Wyomissing Library and at the Highlands. The Crown Plaza stepped forward. Also, the City of Reading 13th and Green School to the Cottage at the Reading School Welcome Center. Maxitoni 1 from Zion's Church to the Township Building. Muhlenberg 4 from Sacred Heart to Township Building. Exeter 3 from Exeter Village to Lorraine Elementary School. And Maiden Creek 3 from Keystone Assisted Living to Trinity Church. We met with representatives of Santander Arena yesterday, and we're pleased to report that there are at least four polls in Reading which are not available June 2nd, so we are going to be setting up four individual polls on the floor at the arena. It's also going to be a location to pick up supplies the Saturday before the primary and actually return the product on the night of June 2nd. Also going to be opening that up for training, because there still needs to be training on the new system. The Judge of Elections will be training at the Ag Center, and the machine inspectors, 200 some machine inspectors, will be trained at the Santander Arena. Gives us plenty of physical distancing, and there's 20,000 square feet on the floor. So there's really, when you talk about a crisis like this, people really step forward and support our efforts, and I really want to commend those organizations. And the League of Women Voters have also volunteered to step forward and help us scan ballots after the primary on June 2nd. That is, again, a testament to the spirit of Berks County, that people do this. We're also in discussion right now. Our first priority is the safety of our voters as well as our poll workers. We're looking at additional safety steps to be done at the polls that remain. So at this point, there's 11 polls that still need to be either combined or find other locations to do so. So I'll continue to report that every other week so people are aware of the changes. The last meeting we had here, we discussed the rate of taxation of county bills. And yesterday, along with Commissioner Rivera, was on the call. I don't know if Commissioner Linebach got on a little bit later. But CELG, the Center for Excellence in Local Government, had a Zoom call, 133 representatives on the call, to discuss the county moving the flat period out to June 30th. It appears that the majority on the call supported also moving municipal billing out to September 30th. There wasn't a dissenting voice on the phone. So pursuant to that, the county sent out a cover letter and a sample resolution for the townships and the boroughs to consider to extend their period out to September 30th as well, to partner up with the county's move. That way, that tax bill that was delivered to your home early in March, the discount period ends April 30th, so the flat period would extend from May 1st through September 30th. And we're hoping that the overwhelming number of municipalities support the move to September 30th. There was further discussion about other taxes that the municipalities collect, and the terrible plight that they're all in with earned income tax, real estate transfer tax, commuter tax in the city of Reading, and some amusement taxes that are collected throughout the community. So we hope all of this, we get back to normal as soon as possible, because not only are taxpayers suffering, but so are the municipalities that provide 24/7 police coverage and public works and water and sewer services. Last but not least, I would be remiss if I didn't continue to pound the pavement for Census 2020. Please go online, 2020census.gov, or call 844-468-2020, and please complete your census form. Our Our rate countywide is about normal. Our rate in some areas is below normal. There shouldn't be any reason why we don't have 10 minutes out of our time, since most of are sheltered in place, to either pick up the phone or go online and complete a very simple 10 questions about the census. Again, 2020census.gov or 844-468-2020. Thank you, Commissioner Linebach.
Thank you very much, Commissioner Barnhart. And we'll turn now to Commissioner Rivera.
Yep.
Do I need to do an enhanced introduction for you as well?
No, I'm fine.
Would you like me to try to do it in Spanish?
That would be good.
Yeah, it's not going to happen.
Well, I thought you would after you threw me under the bus in yesterday's press conference, but...
I wasn't going to even bring that up.
Well, first of all, I'd like to, again, thank everyone who's doing their part to help stop the spread and just trying to have some normalcy in our lives. We had a call with BCIU and the school district superintendent, and I want to thank them for the work they're doing to try to keep the education going for our kids, to keep them engaged in school, and to make sure that they're able to finish their grade that they're in right now and that they're ready to start next year. So thank you to all the people at BCIU, to the school district, the superintendents, the teachers that are out there doing their jobs day after day, engaging with the kids and making sure that they're receiving the education that they need so that it does not impact them now and in the future. I also want to thank again the healthcare workers that are out there day after day, the first responders who put their health at risk every day to go out and do their job. The businesses that are following the guidelines, wearing masks, doing social distancing, taking care of their employees and of the clients as well, thank you for that. The Do Your Part, Stop the Spread campaign is going strong. We have the posters on the doyourpartberks.com website, so please go on there. We also have a social media campaign going on as well. If you want to support that, please reach out to my office, and I'll give you more information on that. And you can also find more information on the doyourpartberks.com website. The COVID Help Center has been going strong. As of yesterday, we have answered 1,738 calls and 579 emails. Again, that's they're able there to answer any question related to COVID. You can email them at covid@countyofberks.com. Again, that's covid@countyofberks.com. And the phone number is 610-320-6150. Again, 610-320-6150. And last but not least, is yesterday was Administrative Professionals Day. And this week we are celebrating, and my wife said it's the whole week, so we are celebrating Administrative Professionals Week. So thank you to all the administrative professionals out there keeping us in line. I want to especially thank Barbara Lopez, who's my executive assistant, Mary Buer, and Jessica Blauser, who are the executive assistants to Commissioner Linebach and Commissioner Barnhart. Without you three, we could not do our jobs. It would be a lot harder. Thank you for keeping us in line. That's all.
Thank you very much. I know Mary Buer's watching. I was going to take you out to Judy's for lunch, but they're closed, so we'll have to wait till next year. I'll take you out next year.
What a guy.
Try to remind me.
Well, actually, most places have curbside pickup where you can get the lunch for them. That's an option as well. Yeah. Just wanted to throw that out there.
Yeah, to throw me under the bus yet again. If you haven't noticed, a little bit of humor in the middle of these crazy times is a healthy thing. So don't be offended at humor in the middle of the COVID-19 crisis that we're facing. I want to touch on several things. First of all, the mask that I'm wearing, I didn't know until yesterday that we were going to actually have them in hand. This is made by a local company, Elite Sportswear. Elite Sportswear makes gymnastic outfits, swimming fashion. They're very well known. I think they actually go by GK Elite Sportswear. And they're one of the local companies that said, okay, we're going to reconfigure They reached out to the county a couple of weeks ago to let us know that they could make cloth masks available to us. And so this is one of the GK Elite Sportswear cloth masks. We did purchase them from them, and we got them when they said we would. So that's a good thing, because when it comes to PPE, anybody that's been following anything, just because you place an order, just because you have a purchase order, and even may put money down, doesn't mean you're going to actually get it. It's been a very difficult process. I also want to highlight another business, actually up in Schuylkill County. Eight Oaks Farm Distillery is a family-owned, veteran-owned business in New Tripoli, and they're right there. They consider themselves really part of the Lehigh Valley area, and they donated 100 cases of hand sanitizer to Berks County Department of Emergency Services. It's being distributed to appropriate departments in the county and to local first responders. We really appreciate them doing that. Their business has been largely shut down, and I am sure that a lot of entities would have paid for this, but they understood who the people are on the front lines. And I just want to really thank the owners of Eight Oaks Farm Distillery. I'm carrying around a little container, and my son, if you remember, made my mask with the skeletons on it, made a bunch of these, got the little bottles, made hand sanitizer. It's making sure everyone at our house, there's four of us living there, carry these around with us. He also has a homemade spray bottle that when I come home, three of them work out of the house. I was voted off the island 2 weeks or so ago. I was told I was too loud. Can anyone imagine that? I don't know, but I left the island. So when I come in, he sprays all my stuff right at the front door. And you know what? I compliment him. He's doing everything he can to protect me, to protect my wife, and to protect himself and his girlfriend as well. I just want to thank everyone for what you're doing. And as we come to the end of this, or close to the end of this meeting, want to direct your attention to the website doyourpartberks.com. Look at the message that we're delivering. I know there's a lot of controversy about who should be open, who should be closed. Our belief is the debate shouldn't be about who's open or closed. The debate should be about what businesses are able and willing to implement effective health and safety standards to limit the spread of COVID-19. We want to encourage you that even when businesses broadly reopen, it's going to be just as important to continue to practice effective health and safety standards to limit the spread of COVID-19. The doyourpartberks.com website will remain active as long as there is a significant threat from COVID-19. Not only are there great resources, links to posters that you can download and print for your business or your home, links to data. Just a couple days ago, I put the link up from the state that shows cases by zip code throughout the entire state, but you can zoom in and look at Berks County. And I want to encourage you, some people are misreading it already. They look, that's a Reading zip code. That's a Reading zip code. That's a Reading. It's all in Reading. Why missing? 19610. Is listed as a Reading zip code. 19611 is a Reading zip code. 19601, which is legitimately City of Reading, is a Reading zip code. So please understand that places like Muhlenberg Township, I believe parts of Maiden Creek Township, parts of Exeter, Mount Penn, West Reading, Wyomissing, all of those are a zip code that's labeled as Reading. So feel free to look at that information. on that website, but remember, we need you to do your part. We're going to be adding a section, again, at no cost. Kim Worley is adding a section to celebrate businesses that are doing their part. We already have Weaver's Hardware information. It's not up yet. She's putting a section together. We heard about Anawalt's landscaping. They have our posters throughout their business promoting Do Your Part. And I also want to highlight the social media campaign that several people are just doing a great job posting pictures of how they are doing their part. With that said, there are no row officers here, and I'm looking to see if any of them may have commented. Now, Mary Buer, she keeps a close watch on me. So, Mary, this is for you. I saw an email just come up. It said, read comments. She was afraid that I'm going to forget to read the comments. I didn't forget, Mary, but that's why I love you so much. You are always looking out to make sure I do the right thing. So thank you very much, Mary Buer. So let's go into comments. There are a total of three comments. And because these were actually questions, we do not ignore them. Mary checks on them. And if they are questions, instead of waiting, having people wait for this meeting, she's taking care of each of them. This first one is from William Sturm, Leesport, Pennsylvania. The county recycling facility on Hilltop Road in Burn Township is closed. While I completely understand and support the need for social distancing, this closure is short-sighted. While COVID-19 is a serious and deadly disease and all precautions to prevent its spread must be taken, this pandemic will eventually end, whether in a month, 6 months, or even a year. However, the damage we are doing to the earth by throwing our recyclables into the trash instead of recycling will have a negative effect on the earth and the environment in which we all live for generations to come. There should be ways to ensure social distancing while recycling glass, plastic, paper, and cardboard. Think long term, not just the present. This is more than appropriate since we are celebrating Earth Day this week. We sent this to Jane Meeks. Jane Meeks is the executive director of the Berks County Solid Waste Authority, and they run the specific recycling facility in Burn Township. Her response is, Mr. Sturm, the county has asked me to respond to your email regarding the recycling center currently being closed due to safety issues related to COVID-19. The issue at the center is that once the materials are dropped off, they must be processed to be packaged for market. All of the paper and cardboard must be touched by my staff to remove all the trash that is typically in with the recycling, styrofoam, plastic bags, food, etc., so it can be put into our baler on site and sent to market. At this point, this is not safe since so many people are infected without their knowledge. Most recycler haulers are still providing curbside recycling services. Since their materials are sent to large material recovering facilities for processing, which for the most part is done by machine rather than by hand as ours is, there are two facilities located in Berks County, but I'm not sure if they are allowing residents to drop off their materials at this time. They are Kugel's Recycling in Hamburg and Total Recycle in Birdsboro. I can tell you that Kugel's is accepting. As recently as this past weekend, I took recycling to Kugel's in Hamburg. Our main goal in having our facility closed during this uncertain time is to keep our employees safe so that once the stay-at-home order is lifted by the governor, we can open as quickly as possible and have good, reliable, healthy employees to process the recyclables that are brought to our center. Thanks. Please feel free to reach out with any further questions. I don't think the others are quite as long. This next question is from Bill Landis. School, county taxes, and county taxes should be given extension of the date due by at least 2 months. Mary Buer responded, thank you for your email. The Berks County Commissioners already took action two Thursdays ago at our commissioners meeting in anticipation of the legislature and governor's action. We did not move the discount period, but we did move the 10% penalty period from July 1st to October 1st. The county has no jurisdiction to address or move the school tax deadlines. And then I think this is the last one. I'll look at my inbox before I comment. This is from Phyllis Yoder. May I please have an application for back tax payment hardships? You can email the form to me, and she is from a Reading, PA address. And in this particular case, Mary Buer connected this individual to Stacy in our tax claim department. Also, just as an FYI, there is no application for a hardship agreement. It will be offered to everyone by default upon request. And let me just go in here to my inbox. There are no additional comments. Any other comments from my colleagues?
How about motion to adjourn?
I'll take a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Meeting is adjourned.